Because, you know, if she loses, then, you know, the whole team's momentum is going to go down. Unless they just don't care, and then they're like, oh, no, that's not our best.
Just like she go first, yeah.
And they go Super Saiyan 3.
Maybe.
Super Saiyan 2. Z hasn't been streaming because of his new sponsorship.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that makes sense.
So Z needs to make a new channel.
Are you Armo is Wumbo?
Oh, Sheep's going Toon Link.
Okay, she's
I know she has one.
She is going back to her roots, going with Toon Link.
But honestly, I think Rosalina has the better advantage here.
Yeah,
it's weird to see Toon Link going out, but we'll see.
Okay. So the match is starting. Sheep starts off with taking out a bomb, throwing bombs to the Pikmin, trying to kill them.
That's a good strategy. And I mean, I guess this can be a good matchup. And yeah, up tilt.
She needs to use those up tilts to take out those Pikmin.
Yeah.
Oh, try to.
I don't think she's that well informed about this matchup because, I mean, I'm pretty sure up tilt hits the Pikmin, but. I could be wrong.
Now, she can't get this in her, like, she can't get this messed up in her head. She can't get angry.
Yeah.
Because she tends to get angry at times when she's losing.
Well, a lot of people get angry when they play, when they start losing.
Yeah, but she gets, like, super angry.
That's
like,
true.
Like, hits you angry.
Really?
She hit me.
Oh.
She hit me when I beat her. But anyways, try to get that bomb, but the platform was in the way. Douglas doing a great job using his Pikmin to stay on Sheep there. Keeping that purple Pikmin
on deck.
Just for that final
Kill.
Four, yeah. Okay. Sheep not letting those Pikmin affect her, but she needs to start using those up tilts to kill the Pikmin so she can just go in. But it's pretty hard because Toon Link is not known to go in.
Yeah. He really relies on his projectile game. I mean, some of those projectiles can hit the Pikmin, so... Oh, got rid of the purple, and there's another purple.
Douglas is just so lucky with those Pikmin nose.
Ooh, there we go.
All right, nice back throw.
I think Sheep's starting to get the matchup a little bit.
Let's just hope she doesn't get super salty.
Yeah.
All right. I feel like as long as Sheep takes off one or two stocks, it should be fine.
Oh, yeah.
It'll be fine.
Ooh, nice. Is that going to kill?
Yo!
Yep.
Let's go, Sheep.
With the rage on Toon Link's back throw.
Let's go, Sheep.
He's able to kill.
Sheep feeling herself now.
Nope, not yet. Ooh, the purple hit there. Yeah, that's going to take it.
Okay.
But although it's even, so. Up tilt. Oh, okay.
Very wise choice of throwing bombs instead of arrows. Just so the it attacks the Pikmin as well.
Yeah.
Because I feel like her arrows just go over the Pikmin.
Yeah, they do.
All right. Douglas doing his Pikmin thing. Trying to just throw it out towards Sheep and trying to see if he could punish any of Sheep's mistakes there.
Yeah.
All right, got that big damage white Pikmin, but sadly it died. All right. And he has two purple Pikmin.
Oh, this is
scary.
Yeah.
This is very scary for Sheep. All right.
Oh, nice grab attempt there.
Yes.
He has lost one purple, so.
Okay. Douglas has stage control. Both trying to just zone out each other, trying to find an opportunity to attack.
Yeah. It's basically just who can just throw things at each other for the longest time and then get the kill.
It's whoever's the least patient here.
Yeah.
And I feel like Sheep's holding up her end here, doing a great job, but it looks like she's off stage. Okay, good job at going backstage, keeping her ledge.
Oh,
no, Sheep, don't worry about that, Sheep.
Yeah,
don't.
I don't want random up smashes like that.
Yes.
I hope that does. She just needs to regain her composure.
Okay, they're randomly singing Pokemon. I don't understand because it's Olimar versus
Yeah, Toon Boy.
Yeah.
That's weird. Well, I liked what Sheep tried to do there with the bomb.
Try to make her
put a little more pressure on the ledge.
Yes.
And she needs a lot more projectile pressure, but that's really hard when the Pikmin is like on her.
Yeah.
Pokemon.
Okay. Wrong.
Oh. She just needs one more stock.
I feel like all she needs is no Sheep.
No. Oh.
Let's look at her.
No. She's okay.
She's okay. She okay?
Yeah, she's okay.
Okay.
You can see it on the player cam. Did you forget that's there?
I forgot that's there.
Good job, KVP. Yes, this is a crew battle. All right, so I wonder who they're going to send in now.
It's right there. Drayquaza.
Oh. No, it's not.
It is.
Stop it. That says Sheep. What, do you think they're going to send in Drayquaza?
Yes. Okay, so right now, Hotline Bling is up 2 stocks.
That's pretty good.
And Niggas Love Chicken.
Oh, Drayquaza.
Going.
You were right.
Yes, he's going for Charizard. Damn. But that's not his color.
That's not... Oh,
no.
He's going to lose now because of the colors. Oh, man.
Usually he likes to use the purple Charizard, but for some reason he picked the red one. I don't know if it was
He needs to channel the inner Ridley. I mean...
I think he's feeling the rage. He picked the red Charizard.
Wow.
Nope. I was right.
Wow.
I was right. He picked the wrong color.
Yeah, he attacked. You didn't see that?
Oh, I didn't notice that. I didn't notice that. I'm sorry, guys.
Really, KVP? Really?
No, but look, he's going to change his color, too.
Oh, God.
Come on, Drayquaza.
Anyway, enough about colors.
All right.
Here we go.
3. John Cena! Is he allowed to pick... take out his Pikmin before the...
I
don't think that's fair. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
That's true. Okay, Drayquaza trying to keep Alf off stage.
Oh, yeah.
But that red Pikmin all over Charizard, like Charizard is mom or something.
Charizard's a fire type. The red Pikmin shouldn't even affect it.
Yeah,
this game is so stupid.
That
now.
Is so dumb.
Yeah.
All right, but he's using a psychic Pikmin, so it's at least doing some damage there.
Neutral damage.
Too bad the Pikmin's...
Ice Flamethrower.
Yes.
Oh, I don't think I agree with that.
He is... seems like his Pikmin is taking the blow for Alf there. All right.
Yeah, using Flare Blitz in this matchup I don't think is
that's not a good idea. All right, Charizard trying to get in.
I mean, Charizard has Rage. One good charge down smash read, I think, can end it.
Yes, you're right.
Ooh, nice neutral air.
Now, Drayquaza isn't known to be campy or very patient.
No.
He is known to be aggressive.
Yeah.
So you're going to see a lot of dash-ins with him. All right, is he going to do a safe?
Ooh.
No, that was so close.
He tried it there.
Yes, he tried. If he only released that a little sooner, I think he would have got him there. All right, nice fair by Charizard. Is he going to do a down smash here? I mean, a down air? Nope.
No.
He nice didn't. Coverage with the Nair. He's looking for something. Okay, good job. There we go.
Nice up air.
There we go.
Now, Drayquaza needs to hold on to one more stock.
Easier said than done against Alf.
You never know, dude.
All right.
Oh, that's too much damage.
It's okay. It's Charizard. He can live.
Oh, he tried to go for the spike.
He has 328 HP. That was weird. He tried using the up smash to take out the Pikmin, but it seems like the wings missed them completely. Nice punish.
Yeah, I don't think he should have went for that Flare Blitz there.
Yeah.
He was too far away.
Flare Blitz is a bad idea.
Yeah. Although Douglas putting in a lot of work in these crew battles right now.
Yes. He is really good in crew battles.
Yeah.
Okay, red Pikmin all over Charizard again, but it's not very effective.
Oh, the blue one's on. That's water.
Yeah, there's a... No, I think it's ice, so it's not effective.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It's neutral, though.
Okay.
It's neutral.
Good job. Drayquaza...
Drayquaza takes it.
Drayquaza takes it. And
although SK's team at a disadvantage right now.
Well...
But if Drayquaza gets pretty good reads...
Let's see who they have left. They have
true.
Skinny.
Yeah.
They have...
Vash.
Vash, and they have Snoop.
Last they could send Skinny in next.
Am I allowed to say DVDA? No. All right. Yeah, well, last DVDA, I remember watching Drayquaza beat Snoop's Yoshi 2-0, two-stocked.
When was this?
This was like DVDA 8 or 9 or something like that.
That wasn't the last one.
It was after pools. Okay, shut up. All right, they are picking Vash. I feel like this is a bad idea.
Did they pick Vash?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I mean...
Because Drayquaza is so aggressive. He's just going to keep going in. He's just going to throw him out, and he's just going to gimp him.
Well, I know Vash has a good record against Drayquaza. I know that for a fact. Don't ask me for the stats again, but I know this for a fact. But who knows, maybe Drayquaza will Mega Evolve into that Mega Charizard.
There's no Smash Ball in here.
No one cares. I want the Smash Ball.
All right, back to the game.
All right.
Drayquaza taking off. Anything he needs to take out two stocks here. Okay. All right. So what Drayquaza needs to do is Gimp Vash.
Yep. Oh, did they
just throw him off.
All right, whatever.
Just throw him off.
Oh, yeah.
No countdown, just went straight in.
Yep.
Nice rock smash to cover.
Here
so.
We go.
There we go.
Oh, I thought we were going to see it.
Oh my gosh, that's such an early
that
kill.
That was good. That was good. I mean, one thing you are going to see from Charizard at the ledge when Vash is off stage is a lot of flamethrower.
Yes.
Because that will keep rack up the damage on the little Mac and keep him off.
Drayquaza staying on that platform just to...
He's going
to
play it cheesy. He's just going to camp, which... It's fine.
Which is a
the
good
crew,
idea.
The crew needs it at this point.
Yes.
Oh, no. No.
He's reading those air dodges.
Yep.
So he downloaded that way of Vash getting back in.
Oh,
but Vash is going to recover low this time. But he reads that as well.
Wow.
Good read.
Amazing. So Drayquaza bringing this back right now.
Yeah.
And, yep, the stocks are tied right now. 7-7.
I don't think Lil Mac's good at crew battles.
Yeah. Yeah. After this, I don't blame him.
There's so many times he just got gimped.
Mm-hmm. Well, all Drayquaza needs to do right now is just play it cheesy.
Yeah.
Stay back.
That was very close. He could have ended that stock there with that down smash, but slightly off time
that.
Okay, let's see where he's going.
Oh!
If he just waited and did a forward smash, I think that would have...
Yeah.
Okay, he's just going to chill.
Oh, he's going
to
chill.
But he has to watch out for that up B, but I don't think
that
up B is going to
kill. That's not going to kill.
It is not going to kill.
And they have no time limit. So, never mind.
Drayquaza should have just chilled. Yeah, he just... I don't know why he was scared. There was nothing to be scared of.
Yeah. But, you know, Drayquaza did a good job bringing it back.
Yes,
he took two stocks off of Vash, so the next person just needs to come in, take the stocks off.
Okay, Hotline Bling up one stock. So
are we going to see SK or Poyo?
I feel like Poyo should go.
You never
know. Just because it's Little Mac, you know? It's
true.
I don't think they should bring SK too soon.
Well, who do they have? Yeah, because
they have Poyo and... Yeah, so...
Snoop is still there, so they might save him for Snoop. So Poyo might, yeah.
Because SK has a good track record against Snoop.
Yeah.
Oh, my
What are
headset.
The stats on that, though?
What stats?
Don't you know? Who won more, SK or Snoop?
SK has...
You can't tell
it.
Me? Well, no, I want the exact numbers.
Probably like 3-0.
No.
3-0.
Alright, So we're waiting now.
Okay,
pretty sure they're sending in Poyo.
Dasha texts.
Although, where's SK?
Dasha texting his boyfriend Snoop right behind him.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh,
yes.
Poyo.
You were right. Or no, I was right.
You were right.
Poyo is stepping up.
Yep.
And he is gonna put that sword in Little Mac's hoodie.
Nice.
Yes. Okay. I predict that...
I think Vash might be able to take a stock off of his Marv.
Can Vash switch? No, he can't switch.
No, he can't switch.
Not even colors?
You can switch colors. There's nothing against that.
I don't think they should switch colors.
Alright. So I wonder where they're going to counterpick.
Okay, I feel like Poyo is going to go to... Duck Hunt.
Duck Hunt?
Just that. Just because he can camp on that tree.
Yeah, that's true.
And those bushes, too. Could.
Although, I think you also have to consider that there's no time limit. So, I mean, he could camp for as long as he want, but I don't think that's going to be a factor when there's no time.
Oh, it is going to be a factor in their heads.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can't argue with that. Oh. He can't switch.
No.
So...
He's just trying to...
Get in his head?
No, he's just trying to... I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what he's trying to do.
And they're going back to Battlefield.
All right. Let's see.
This is a pretty good stage for Marth.
Good choice. All right. Vash taking one stock. He needs to take another stock out. And we are going to start in...
They're probably just going to run in at each other.
3-2-1.
Nope, they're going.
Okay. All right, nice.
One thing I noticed Poyo doing more now is the extended dash dance.
He knows how to do that. He's been practicing that in the lab, so he's been nailing that consistently now.
Oh, yeah.
All right, good job using that side B to get some percentage off of Ash.
Oh.
Ooh. If he air dodged that, though.
Oh, Air Mac.
Air Mac is out.
Ooh, nice counter.
All right, how is Vash going to... Oh, he just goes straight for the ledge.
All right. KO punch. But he's probably going to save it.
I think if...
Try to get the stock.
I think if Poyo just... No, Poyo, just go up. Just stay up. Just stay up. There we go. Get your... Poyo wants to fight him head on. He doesn't want to play cheaply by staying on the platform.
He might just want to take the stock off now.
Never mind.
He's camping.
There you go. Oh, nice.
Maybe he wanted to get rid of the KO punch.
Yeah.
Just in case.
All right. Is he going to counter? Is he going to counter? No.
Ooh, oh, but he up bees. That's it. All right.
Even match.
Yeah.
Poyo and
so
Snoop.
Who's it going to be? Skinny or
Snoop?
Oh,
no. Poyo and SK versus Skinny. I think if Skinny goes in, it'll be a good match because I've seen the brothers play, and there's some games where Poyo would beat Snoop, like barely.
Well, they play a lot together,
yeah, they're brothers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. It's like, why are you doing an up smash across the stage? Oh, he was doing a momentum shift there.
All right. So, Skinny, I'm not sure where he's going to choose. He might just go Smashville.
So,
or Town and City.
Skinny.
That is a good choice for Donkey Kong.
If Skinny... Okay, so the percentages for Ding Dong for Skinny is if Poyo is at 75 to 80, it's a guaranteed Ding Dong. If Skinny's with no rage. If Skinny has some rage,
yeah,
then it will be probably like 70. And then if he has a lot of rage, it's 60 to 65.
And I was right, Talman City.
All right, good choice by Skinny, using the low ceiling to his advantage. Now, Skinny has to start off with a Congo down throw to a Congo up throw. That would bring the percentage up to 50%.
Yeah. So, right now, boy, I was just going in. Oh, there we go.
Nice use of jab. What I've seen Skinny do is use the first jab and then read what the opponent does so that he can either re-grab or he can do a dash attack. There.
Oh, down here throw. We go.
Nope.
Oh, no.
Poyo knows it. He attacks it and jumps. All right.
Oh, here we go.
Nice. Okay.
Skinny's starting to get momentum.
He is catching him with those up airs. Okay, he's at kill percentage. If he could if he could hit him with the tip of his head.
Oh, I think Skinny was trying to get it
there.
Oh, here we go.
The ding dong.
Yep.
Ding dong. There we go.
Okay. Using that high ceiling to his low ceiling to his advantage. Oh,
okay.
Nice.
Oh, he missed the Congo down throw.
I think he knew Poyo was going to get out of it.
Okay, nice nair trying to get back.
Ooh,
oh,
a tipper nair. That was pretty good.
All right, it's anyone's game here. I feel like DK has a slight advantage on stage, but Poyo has the advantage off stage.
Because of his counter. He can easily just counter the up B, stop his recovery.
All day.
Yep.
All day.
Oh, I like the attempt there. He's realizing Skinny's starting to shield a lot, so he's starting to throw out more of those shield breakers.
Yes. And thanks to the new shield mechanics. Oh, actually,
His shield breaker was nerfed.
Yeah, they nerfed his shield breaker, so it's. It actually made it worse, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, Skinny needs to calm down, bring Poyo to 60%, and end it with that ding dong.
Oh,
okay.
They're close.
All he needs to do is one pummel to the ding dong. It's over.
Nope.
No, he had a pummel. Oh, no, I forgot. It was low ceiling.
Yeah, low ceiling.
Yeah.
Come on, KVP.
I'm sorry. All right, Skinny. Oh, nice. But Poyo read that, jumps out of it again. Nice sword dance there. All right. Counter.
Oh,
there
we go.
All day.
This is going.
He's gonna keep. Okay, and then he's gonna punish this. There we go.
I was gonna say recovering high was kind of smart there because he probably expected Poyo to use the counter again by the ledge, but Poyo just waited.
If he did up B slightly lower, then he could make him semi-safe.
Yeah. And it's even percentage right now.
All right, Poyo keeping him away with the sword. But Skinny's, or DK's arms and legs are a lot longer.
Yeah, not going to kill.
But he's off, the good thing is he's off of Ding Dong.
True.
Range. So he can't kill with Ding Dong anymore. He has to rely on his back throw or back air at this point.
Oh.
Or up tilt.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
he's fishing. Okay, there we go.
Back throw.
Nice.
Oh, nice.
He's just like slapping him away. Poyo has to watch out.
Oh, yeah, Poyo's starting to struggle. He was doing better earlier in the match, but now it seems like Skinny knows what Poyo wants now. And back air does.
There we go. Closes out with a back air.
Good job by Skinny. But now they have to face SK. So this is going to be a uphill battle for.
Yes. Yes, it
Hotline
will.
Hotline Bling.
Let's go, Hotline Bling.
Wow. Bias much?
No. Let's go, Niggas Love Chicken.
Now, where's SK? Oh, there he is. Okay.
Now, if SK doesn't come here in about 30 seconds, he's going to be DQ'd.
He's here. He's here.
Oh, my butt.
Okay. Right? These seats are so uncomfortable.
Okay. All right, so one of the veterans, SK92, versus one of the newcomers, Skinny.
This will be interesting. I feel like Skinny could do it if he just keeps his cool.
Now, because Fox is the fast follower and he's a lot lighter, I mean, yeah, he's a lot lighter.
Oh, yeah, sure. All right, well, I got a match.
All right.
See you later, KKP.
Good luck. Good luck, Xantha. So what I was saying was he could actually ding-dong Fox at from 65% with Outrage and 55 to 60% with Rage. You know what he's going to do? He's going to do random aerials. All right. Okay, so SK being really patient here, he knows all he needs to do is take out one stock. Okay, good forward air to up air there. Skinny doing a random up B, and SK missing that punish there. Nice dash attack to Nair, and he's just going to keep Skinny off by using that Nair there. Looks like I'm going to be joined by Zero.exe here. All right, good stage control by SK92, and try to do a hard read, thinking Skinny would roll back, but Skinny's smarter than that. All right. Nice.
What's up, everybody? Let's hope I can do a better job commentating than I can playing Smash Bros. Holy crap, I've never been more embarrassed in my life. Cow, I hope you weren't watching that. That was bad. I will say I got my partial revenge in singles, though. I had to play Hebrew Hammer, and I took the stock off in both of the games I played.
That's good. That's good.
No, they were much closer, though. I went with Zero Suit instead of Roy, and it was it ended up a lot better. Oof.
Good job closing that stock.
So this is 3-3 now, right?
It is 3-3. Oof. Both the team captains, SK92 versus Snoop.
Oh, Lord. I don't know who I'd rather face, because the winner of this is going to grand finals against my crew.
Ooh.
And hopefully I can get some redemption. I mean,
your crew is EXO, right?
EXO,
yeah.
Hino.
EXO did.
EXO, Kinzer, and... Yeah, and Hino.
EXO did really good.
Kinzer was the MVP. Holy crap.
Man. Oh, man, dude. Beasting. Yeah. I feel... How do you feel of Little Mac and Cruz?
That scares the crap out of me.
I don't care how
many, I don't care how many stocks that Little Mac has. I do not want to have to fight a Little Mac.
Okay.
Because, Vash is on one of these crews then, right? I assume that's why you're asking?
Yes.
Which one is he on?
He's on Snoop's crew, but he, from today, he got, what's it called? He got gimped.
Did he really? Okay.
Yeah, a lot. So, I was just wondering, I was like, is Little Mac worth crew battles, or I don't know.
That's a tough one. I'm just scared of Little Mac in general, just because, like, oh, man, I played Bash in tournament, and he's beaten me, so, I mean, like,
oh, yeah,
Little Mac as a character is scary. I mean, if you've got a good projectile game and a good offstage game, you know, someone like Lucas, for example, shouldn't have any problems with a Little Mac.
Yes, exactly. But he is not a for glory Little Mac, that's for sure.
Yeah. So, I mean, maybe as a counter pick, because then you could pick, like, Final Destination so that you can at least set him up for some success.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's a tough one. I definitely wouldn't lead with a Little Mac. Where you have to play on a neutral stage. I would definitely...
I would not, yeah. Maybe cleanup.
Yeah, exactly. Sending him in for cleanup, maybe. Because then, like I said, you can pick the stage that would benefit Little Mac the best, like a Final Destination or even Town and City, something wide that has a lot of stage for him to run around on. Okay, so here we go. Final set, 3-3.
Looks like they're going to Town and City. So the track record is SK92... Would at PSG, he would always beat Snoop.
Yeah, I played Snoop a couple times in tournament. He's really good, but SK92, he's something else, man. He's definitely one of the best ones here. This Fox is just scary.
All right, nice use of Snoop's Nair beating out SK's up tilt there.
Yeah, he's doing a really good job, man, not getting stuck in the usual shenanigans Fox likes to catch you in.
Forward smash by Snoop.
Oof.
Ooh, and missed another forward smash.
Oh, here we go. Oh, nice. The tech prevents him from getting caught in that fair.
Snoop getting out of there. Snoop needs to get back on stage here.
Oh, yeah.
Does a great job there. Ooh.
Now, I'm wondering if he can Nair out of that.
Probably.
That's something I like to do with Luigi. Like, as they're trying to do the combo, like, try to fastball with a Nair.
Okay, up airs with Ooh, nice, nice.
And we're just about at an even match now.
SK doing a great job going all over Snoop. Snoop having a hard time getting back in the middle of the stage.
That looked like a really big punish opportunity for SK92.
What SK likes to do is either the down air to up smash or the side B to up air.
Yeah.
There we go.
Or just a raw up smash. That'll do it.
saw the punishable down smash.
Yeah, Snoop's got to take control of this match again because he was off to a hot start. You know, it was like 61-6 at one point. Now it's like he's about to get lapped. there it is. The Fox combos for days. Oh, nice. Using the egg to break out of that.
Nice snare.
There we go.
But we shouldn't count off Snoop. He's known to take out names. Yes. Trying to use a back air to keep him away. All right, SK doing a great job staying in the middle of the stage.
SK looked like he was fishing for an up smash there.
Yes.
With rage, that might have done it. Oh, nice. Beautiful.
But Yoshi brings it back with his up air.
So just about even. SK92 has no rage now, so an up smash definitely won't kill now. I'm not sure if it would before, but I'm certainly not going to do it this time.
Now, is Yoshi going to start using his shenanigans with his command grab?
Yeah, you know what? Now that you mention it, I haven't seen him really do that a whole lot. Probably because he doesn't want to get punished. It's a really long move. I mean, at least 60 frames. At least in the air.
All right, trying to fish for those dash attacks.
Looks like he doesn't want to overcommit to it. Using a lot of aerials.
Yeah.
Try to space him out and zone him out.
Looks like Snoop's still trying to feel for it, but nice. SK's all over him.
That was a really good up smash, though. He's been using that forward air a lot, knowing that he's going to hit his shield, just going for the shield pressure. Ah, there it is.
You were right. He tried to do the command grab and got punished for that.
That's probably why we haven't seen it so far. Okay, so this is it. I mean, this is his tournament stock here.
Now
for the crew battle.
Is Snoop going to clutch it out, or is SK just going to take the money?
Oh, man. That was a clutch sidestep. Speaking of clutch.
Ooh.
It's not terrible right now. If Snoop can close out this stock. Oh,
and
there
he
We have just about an even match once again.
All right.
Oh, wow.
Nice safe jabs, and it looks like Snoop's just throwing out safe
moves. To the rescue.
Nice dash attack. Ooh.
He's got to get something together going now.
Yeah. SK is feeling himself right now. Nice snares.
Interesting. He was trying to see how he reacted to that approach there. It's just the area that's up.
These two are just doing some footsies here.
That was scary. Good thing he was close to the edge, otherwise that could have been an up smash.
All right, let's see if SK is going to close it out here. He tried to... he thought Snoop was going to recover high, but he didn't. Missed that up there.
Oh! That was an opportunity. Man, that was crazy. Still pretty close. I'm just really terrified of that up smash from Fox. I mean, that could come at any time. Snoop doing a good job of keeping it close, though.
Yes.
Let's
bring it back.
Do it!
Snoop brings it back.
Clutch.
That was so clutch. And Hotline Bling takes it.
Wow.
Beats niggas love chicken.
Well then.
Oh my gosh.
That was something. The run back for singles. This is going to be fun. Okay. Shout outs to Tony for making it interesting on stream.
All right, I'm going to go play my match now.
All right, good luck, man.